That bracelet must have cost you a fair bunch, girl.
Whoa, stop.
This ain't no Battlestar Galactica.
Whoa indeed.
Is this Hogwarts? No.
Where on earth is this?
It can't be. No.
Asuka.
Who's there?
And technically not Earth.
Who goes?
Not what you would call Earth, anyway.
I swear to God, asshole, show yourself.
Show myself? I've shown.
Where are you?
Right here, at the end of your arm. Oh, hello, yeah.
Ooh, there's like someone living on this chick's arm.
So let me get this straight.
Ew.
I'm somewhere that's not what I would call Earth. I'm seeing
oh, this looks nice.
Dragons, and oh yeah, I'm talking to a cop.
Ooh.
Did I just do that?
Ooh.
I just moved it with my freaking
She swears. Don't swear.
Yeah, okay. That is something I do now.
Sci-fi, thank you for the sub. Sorry, I'm doing kind of a cheeky stream right now. I just got really excited because I know nothing about the PS5 games that are coming out. Can you hear me okay? I don't know what the levels are like. I just got excited and I jumped on stream because I was like,
you are the only hope we have.
Oh, this game looks awesome. Oh, it's like Assassin's Creed with the Hogwarts and the Prince of Persia. Fuck yeah.
Doing our land a great service.
I mean, you can't go wrong with dragons and the Force and Avatar powers, apparently. Forspoken. Is that because her bracelet is talking to her?
No name for a demon. I am the one you seek, the one and only Tanta Sila.
You got the hot voice, baby. Ooh. Mommy, stop, mommy. Mommy, Amate, mommy. Mommy, why? Why you do this?
For decades.
Of course there's a war movie.
It's been the shield against
game,
the
worst whatever.
Global threats imaginable. Hostage situations. Biological weapons.
Oh, this is just real life.
Threat of nuclear war.
This is just like our world, though.
But now, we face the greatest terror our world
COVID.
Has ever known.
COVID? Extraction. Ooh. Bad time to bring out a plague movie, guys. I don't think this was wise. We might be a bit sensitive to the old zombie movies right now. Oh, yeah. Ooh, I don't like dragons. Ooh. No. Oh, shoot him in the butt. Shoot him in the butt. Oh, I don't like this. No.
If we want a shot at tomorrow,
oh,
we will move as one.
I've been okay. Well, that's a lie. No, I haven't been, but I haven't slept. Sleep is for the weak. Sleep is for the human. I'm obviously not human. I'm an anime character. So apparently, no. I knew he was going to explode. I knew it. Ooh. Ooh, you guys have never seen me play a horror game, have you? I don't do well. I like their outfits, though. I see a lot of people cosplaying this. I'll wear that jacket. I'll wear the fuck out of that jacket. Oh. So they aliens or zombies? Excuse me. Big boy. Rainbow Six. They don't look very rainbowy to me. It needs like 80% more gay. You only got half the colours of the pride flag there. Ooh, this looks official. Ooh. I do love PlayStation. They're so specky with it, you know? They just got that class. The class with it. This better not play any ads, by the way. I have my VPN on, but you never know. Spud kill what you go like you tell people you're fine but you're not really fine.
Stay.
What this? It looks like Stranger Things. Well, life is strange. Oh, I don't like the faces. I don't like this.
Calm down, Mr. Winter.
Calm the fuck down.
I was missing a week. What had happened to
me? Who's this Keanu Reeves looking motherfucker? Oh, we got the Glock though. I used
the flashlight like my life depended on it. With it, I could save myself.
I got a flashlight.
I think the gun is more likely to save your life than the flashlight. That's just me. Oh, the bird. The bird. Oh, the murder.
Carl. Ducky.
I hate how Americans say Carl. Carl. It sounds like Carol. Why are you adding another syllable? I don't understand. Carl. It's Carl.
My name is Alan Wake.
Alan Wake?
I'm a writer.
You don't act like a writer. You're kind of looking up axe murderers and shit. I wonder what kind of fanfics he writes on fanfiction.net. I'd read them. Ooh, that means there's drugs nearby. I know that from Auckland. You see many shoes on the power lines. Oh. I know a lot of people were excited for this. Is it a remake? Yeah, it is. Oh, it's flying right at me. Oh. You get to play tennis? Cool. Seamless character switching. Okay, this game has come quite far from last time I played GTA. What the fuck? Wow. Ooh.
I think we're gonna literally make out like bandits on it.
Uh-huh. Online? Why? Ew. You know people just come here to hook up, probably. Didn't they make a movie about this called Free Guy? Is that Ryan Reynolds? Can I come on his face? Can I come on Ryan Reynolds' face, please? Sprayer. Spray it. I'm a graffiti girl. I love to spray it, spray it. Oh, he did. Oh, he did, though. Oni. An Oni-chan. Yeah, that's me in the morning. Relatable. Oh, no. I've seen this trailer before. No. Oh, this looks scary as fuck. No. The mist. Ah, she farted. It's noxious. Oh.
What was that?
Nani is right. Oh, is that? It's not right. That's not who I thought it was. Was that fucking Slender Man? Oh, hell no. Oh. Who's that artist who everyone loves? He's a horror artist, like the most famous one, Japanese. What's his fucking name? Looks like this though. Looks like this. Especially that bitch with the hat. Junji Ito, that's right, thank you. I fail as a half Asian, I do. I'm Fasian. Of course there's a schoolgirl though. Ooh, little nightmares?
Transformation.
Oh no. You guys will have to hold my hand if I play this shit. No.
A new age will dawn.
It looks like Junji Ito to me. I could be wrong though. Oh, my heart's racing. I can't play that. I'm so serious. Oh shit. Hello, Fizzy to the King. Welcome. You probably hear it in my voice. I can't play horror games. I think I'll have a heart attack. Oh, fuck. Oh, this is scary. Marvel. Oh, my heart. Oh, shit.
Guardians of the galaxy.
You came here seeking truth. Rejoice.
The matriarch wishes...
Spud Kill?
United in the
thank
light
you
of
very
belief,
much, Spud Kill. You gifted subs! If you got a sub, say thank you to Spud Kill. Yeah. Very, very generous of you. Thank you.
What's wrong with
I'm
you?
Happy because I have not streamed in quite some time.
I'm having a heart attack.
Cease this at once.
Oh.
Fine.
Oh, they look different. Different!
How you doing, buddy?
Grand Unifier Acre.
Talking dog. Talking dog.
During that ritual with the priest,
They kept talking about a promise.
It was like they were drinking funky juice or something.
Oh, I like her makeup.
So let us investigate.
I hate his hair. He looks like fucking
not fun kind with
PewDiePie, but like mixed with that Chad meme. Got the fade with a quiff on top. What a chav. He's not Chad, he's a chav. 0.3%. Puppy.
Is that bad? It sounds bad.
It is.
His hair.
One hell of a speech plan, Peter.
Oh, poofed her.
That makes two of us.
I mean it the most affectionate way.
Follow me.
Ooh, buff Groot. Ooh. I mean, it looks more fun than Mass Effect, I must say. I was very impressed with that game.
Honestly, I want to
by rejecting the promise, remake. You have proven yourself unworthy.
I want to see Jack and there, Jack and Dexter as well. I have all the games. I could probably play just the originals. I hope so too, Spudkill. Sorry, I've been in a bad way. But on her way. This is just easy. I'm not going to play a game. Let's just fucking talk and hang out. I need this. I need this right now.
Thanks,
oh, she's got a katana, girl. Bish. Yes. 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 Yes, indeed. This is the first time I've done a reaction or a live react, whatever the fuck you call them. Easy content, right? Dude. The Last of Us, the first one, was dope. One of my favorite games for sure. Even though I don't like horror games. How fucking ever? You do not kill the main character 5 minutes into the fucking game and you don't get daddy-daughter time that everyone like was wishing and hoping for. I just wanted to play as Joel and have Ellie as my sidekick and we have daddy-daughter time because I don't know my father and I like Joel. He's really hot and he's got a fucking amazing southern accent. I just get emotional, man. We was robbed so bad. Hate. And I never got spoiled. I didn't get spoiled. I would have accepted the game if everything was in different events. If we didn't watch this brawly ass bitch built like a damn deep freezer play mini putt on my man Joel's face. If we saw that last, after seeing all the shit she went through, okay, fine. I would have enjoyed the game a lot fucking more than that. Oh, shit. Sorry, rant over. Makes me emotional, man. Joel is my comfort character. Ooh. So much violence. Hello, Rytrigger. It has been a while. I apologize. Spoilers, fuck you. Game's been out for like half a year. You'll live. You'll fucking live.
Who painted up a prison and named it Freedom.
What this?
Locked us all in one repeating day. Their eternity.
This does look like Mass Effect.
An endless party.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Down the rabbit hole. Alright.
Is supposed to be
I like the aesthetic. It's like mine.
A bunch of spaced out science nerds, brainwashed cultists flinging bombs. Whatever these guys are doing,
ooh.
All spewing eons bullshit. So how come I don't remember shit?
So this much swearing in these games now.
My thing is answers.
Ooh.
Who are these people?
I'll be feeling
what
that in the morning.
What do they want with me? And why is she always one step ahead?
I love the look of the game. I love the set dressing. Look at the attention to the detail. Oh, this is definitely Mass Effect. Look at that biotics.
Somebody built this
biotics.
Place. Somebody's sending me these messages from the future, the past, whenever. And some jackass wrecked every plane out here. Is this a contest for them? Some type of experiment? How does this time loop work? Does anybody remember?
Everyone wearing a mask? I ain't slept yet, just so you know. GLaDOS? Is that GLaDOS?
Colt, I want you to remember. I want you to remember.
How does it feel to watch a fake geek girl commenting on all this stuff?
Is that?
I don't.
Damn, I look good.
You look good, yeah? Yeah,
I've imagined myself a way out.
Bought it. Oh, oh, Jesus. What is this Looney Tunes bullshit? This is... Can I play as Bugs Bunny? Can I be Big Chungus? Is it Wabbit season or Duck season? I must know. Fucking slipping on the marbles. Holy crap. You want to hear a bat crack? Oh, there you go. Ah, it was my bat crack. That game did look like fun though. I do like it. Ooh, this is some found footage. Movie. Okay. Okay. With you so far, okay. Ooh. It's about aliens. Devils. Kid Amnesia. Radiohead? What the? Okay. That told us nothing. It told us sweet fuck all.
Taiga showing her age with a back crack. Don't worry, same here. I'm turning 30 in 2 weeks and I'm already experiencing age
W. Yeah, trust me, 30 is where it starts. 30 is when you slam into the wall and you just slide down like a very sad half-cooked pancake. I'm getting Last of Us 2 vibes and I'm emotional. I hate... No. Okay, so it's cute though. Also, thank you for the biddies. Thanks, Lord Toasty Knight. Oh, you can be a dog! And it's a blue healer. Fuck it, you can be a crab. I've always wanted to pinch Ryan Reynolds' butt. Looks round and bouncy like a muffin. Oh no! Oh, okay. They're alright. They're okay. I thought they were dead and they were gonna fucking die, but they're okay. Good job. Oh, is this from Samoa or Hawaii? Ooh. This looks cute! I like this! It looks like it'll make me cry, but in a good way. Ooh. They don't like the pollution, I see. Chia. New Caledonia. I was way fucking off. I'm embarrassed. You can pet the crab. Oh no. I'm crying. Fuck. Oh my god. It's so cute. No. Oh shit. I'm crying. Oh. You can pet the crab. Oh. I wasn't expecting that. Why did they make me cry? I have been awake for like 32 hours, but I'm sure it's not that. The biggest pirate treasure of all time is within our grasp. The crab.
The tusk of Ganesh.
I'm okay.
Now that's not right. An easy fight.
Oh. Is this? It is. Haha.
Last I checked, we're all a bunch of thieves digging around where we shouldn't.
Uncharted. Oh, crap. I love how everything goes wrong for him all the time. It's what they deserve. Aww. My ex-husband used to love this game. That's why I can't play it. It does look good though. Doesn't the remaster look amazing? Normally I'm just like, remasters, oh fuck off, you know. But that actually looks really good. They did a good job. Nathan could get it.
A
Was it a hiss, maybe? Can't prove anything. You can't clip that. PlayStation
Studios, at its heart, is a diverse and passionate group of storytellers.
Passionate.
At our collective of AAA studios all across the globe. Everything we do is driven and inspired by storytelling.
That's
true. As creators, PlayStation 5 gives us the opportunity to push the boundaries of storytelling.
I have one of those.
Even further. Our world-class development teams at PlayStation Studios have already delivered such incredible gaming experiences for PS5, and we're only just getting
started. I play the new Ratchet and Clank,
it sucked. As you'll see today with the lineup of exclusive games coming for PlayStation Studios, we're going to continue to drive innovation, advance gaming, while always embracing the legacy of PlayStation, and creating games that matter. Games that you're not going to find anywhere else.
Yes.
Enjoy.
Exclusivity is what they like, it's what they crave. They crave that mineral. Let's be real. Thank you, PlayStation. Insomniac. All right. More Marvel. What could this be? Ooh. Cowboy. I have a fetish for cowboys. Oh, and he's dirty too. He's a dirty boy. You beat everyone up in here, didn't you? Oh, we got the shiv. He gonna shank it. You gonna get ganked, old timer. Put them knuckles to good news. Oh, it's Wolverine! Fuck! Yeah! Wolverine! Bro! Yes! Oh, Kia Katai! Yes! Ah! He's old as balls and that, but I'm here for it. Is this Speed Racer? Very odd choice of music, isn't it? Gran Turismo?
Welcome to my thing called Gran Turismo.
Race Queen Rosa, thank you very much for the 100 bits. I will proudly announce the very first and last Gran Turismo game that this old gal has ever played was on PS1.
Just came in, got my pineapple Mountain Dew ready and my gamer chips.
Bish Mordecai, thank you for 10 bits. You got the pineapple Mountain Dew? You gonna share? You gonna share? My gremlin status is under attack. I've never had this. It sounds amazing. Oh, that's a sexy beast. I like.
Cars. Pretty pod.
It is, right? TNT Kaboomski, thank you for the 10 biddies. I'm not really into cars, but I can appreciate a sexy one. I very much like the Mazdas and Subarus. Subaru, Subaru, whatever the fuck you call them. Mazda. That car, Delta Bruni, is worth more money than I'll ever make in my life. You can customize the stickers! Yes! I want to be on a car. If you can make VTuber cars, I've seen them. I've seen one of Iron Mouse. I want to be a car. Put my fucking face and asshole on a car. I don't give a fuck. I want to be on a car. Use my nipple rings as a hood ornament. Yes. Oh, goodness. Oh, it looks nice. Oh, yeah. I remember this from the original games. It's so still so classic. Porsche. It's Porsche. You're right, Jakalius. My giant fat ass would ruin the dynamics, aerodynamics of this car. It always hurt me when you like nudge into other people and I just know you're chipping their paint. That hurts me so much. Good old GT. Yeah. I got nipple rings? No. Wouldn't you like to know? Shut up. I didn't say nothing. Yeah, I mean, Dr. Sirius, has anybody got their Dakimakura yet? Anybody? Probably too early to say. But just so you know, yes, they are now in my merch repertoire, and you can see my nipples, and you can see for yourself I do not have nipple rings. But I could. That could be fun. Get my nipples pierced on stream, fuck yeah. Hear me scream. You know, I was making fun of Gran Turismo. It looked cool. Yep, I want my ass on a car. Yep.
For as long as I can remember, I have looked for an equal. One who could
oh my god. Oh.
One who could surprise me.
The bisexual energy.
One who could even beat me.
Miss Buddy said, "Ah! Team up! Team up!"
That all I found was disappointment.
Oh, they're friends. And they were roommates.
Be one of you.
His thitties, oh my god. Peter Parker, your thitties. Your giant tits. There's B cups for sure. Oh. Let's go. No. It's Venom. 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 Venom! Yeah! Can you play as Venom? Holy shit. Venom! 2023! Fuck you! 2023! Why the fuck are you showing this at your 2021 showcase? No! Bad PlayStation! Bad! Oh my god! 2023! I'll be dead by then! I'll have cardiac arrest how long you make me wait for these motherfucking games. Oh my god. I'm hyped now. I want to play it now. Fuck off, Kratos. I want to play Spider-Man now. Ugh. When's this coming out? When's this coming out, huh? When Trump's re-elected. Yeah, I'm sure.
Father, I have returned. I bring wares.
Time is running out.
My cat's annoying me, sorry.
Fimbulwinter leads to Ragnarok. War is coming.
He's got a boy? Little boy. Oh.
My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there.
Who are we hunting?
Finding out who I am. Who Loki is.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with God.
Oh.
I don't want to fight anymore.
Loki's a chick.
I just want answers.
And if those answers lead to war with Asgard.
Maybe that's what Mother wants.
I'm hearing a lot of words that's used in like the Marvel movies and I'm very confused. Is this related at all?
I recognize that dour expression anywhere.
I found. Oh my god, is that his head?
Odin's got tricks up his sleeve.
I've never played a God of War game, so I'm very confused.
What if there was someone who could help us?
You mean Tyr? What? The old God of War in these lands, who is dead.
Well, for a dead
the attention
man,
to detail, the two like little crinkles on the back of the head that bald guys have.
If he's out
see
there,
it? Yeah.
Gotta find him.
He fucks. That means he's got a muscular neck.
We're
trying to he looks like that chick from Horizon?
What if the only way to do that is war?
Oh, that's rude. His magnetism.
Is not the only way.
Excuse me.
Stop thinking like a father for a moment and start thinking like a general.
No.
It's normally the opposite. It's normally in like father-son stories, they're like, I want you to treat me like a son. This one's like, no. Don't treat me like a son. Let's go fuck shit up and go to war. Is that Thor? Oh, he looks a bit different. Where's my Hemsworth? I want big bar of titties, himbo energy. Oh, shit. Oh!
Moments of crisis. Panic does nothing.
Oh, he's kicking the shit out of a centaur.
So
always wanted to do that. He's riding a fucking Patronus out here. He's struck, boy.
Tyr.
Mommy? Keanu Reeves?
Coming with us?
It's time to return to movies.
Bring Brandon Fraser. He's been there long enough.
You guys hear Brandon Fraser's coming back?
Well, some of them.
Oh my god, I love your hair. Yes. Yes. Who are you? But I love you. I'll adopt you on the fucking spot. Yeah, Brendan Fraser came out about sexual abuse that he suffered. And he got basically blacklisted from Hollywood forever because his abuser was really high up. And his abuser was like, oh nah, you're never going to work in Hollywood again because you spoke out against me. So, yeah. Poor thing. Now he's coming back. Thanks to Terry Crews, who also came out about his abuse. And people actually took him seriously. Good on them. Love to see my kings rising up.
Ooh, that's slick.
Are they really doing ads for their own shit? I already have one of these. You don't have to sell me on it. Trust me. Oh, wait. I have a prop for this. Give me like a sec. I have a prop. I'm breaking like the third wall here. Hang on. Oh. Come here, tech. Technologic. Here we go. Haha. Look what I made for myself. Ha. Is it too big? I'm playing my PlayStation right now. What are you doing? My custom PlayStation controller. Yaz. Is this how you hold it?
And that was the PlayStation showcase. We've got
info
and updates coming right now.
No.
And I'm in fact joined by no less than PlayStation Studios head Herman Holst. Herman, really strong showing here from PlayStation Studios tonight, including an awesome new look at GT7 and finally a release date.
Thanks, Jim.
GT7 is coming in March, German? And I don't think fans are going to be disappointed with what Yamauchi-san and Polyphony have been working on. And what we're doing with GT7 is we're pulling from the entire history of the franchise, taking some of the best features into
look
GT7. GT campaign, arcade missions, all that good stuff.
And
you know, I got a chance to play, and it just looks and plays sensationally.
Doesn't
the haptics,
it look amazing?
The you feel the rolls, the pull,
well,
the
TNT Kaboomski, I am 3 hours late to the stream. I think they're playing it on a loop, though. Maybe kind of it's hard to tell.
You feel like you're an incredible racer, and for me, that's great.
I am
great
an incredible
to hear that
racer.
About GT7. I can't wait to play that. But I also really wanted to talk about Insomniac. I mean, this is a studio that is absolutely on fire.
They
the
play
last
some. They made some
year,
of my favorite games.
18 months with Marvel Spider-Man, Miles Morales, Ratchet and Clank, A Rift Apart, and now two big reveals tonight in the form of Marvel Spider-Man 2 and Marvel's Wolverine.
That's they could have given us a longer trailer, couldn't
you
they?
You work really closely with Insom, Herman. So what can you tell
acceptable.
Us about just why Insom gets so fired up about the Marvel Universe?
I mean, Sid, you said it. Insomniac are fired.
PB and
so
Jebby.
And
thank you very much.
Insomniac,
thank you.
Really
oh my God, I got six arms.
Challenging themselves to raise the bar with their approach to storytelling
thank you.
And
thank you for subscribing. Resubscribing,
really
I should say. Yeah, where's the Sly Cooper fucking reveal? I swear there was going to be Sly Cooper, right?
That, they really
I thought so.
Nice collaboration amongst their team. And that collaboration that also extends to the way that they work with other PlayStation.
We got a really half-assed
Ratchet
and Clank game. I tell you what, it was awful, so bad.
And that collaboration resulted in the amazing first two Marvel Spider-Man games. And I know that Insomniac are extremely excited to be further expanding the universe into Marvel Spider-Man 2 now.
Actually, when the stream first started, it was really laggy.
You know, in terms of immersion, action, visual fidelity, I think Marvel Spider-Man 2 will be a spectacular showpiece for gaming. And they're also so thrilled to then bring gamers an emotional and a suspenseful journey into Marvel's Wolverine.
Yeah, but that's all you get from the trailer, though.
PlayStation fans are really in for a treat over the next few years.
Very cool. Very
2023 is what they mean.
And on multiple fronts. Tonight, we also got our first big look at God of War Ragnarok. Herman, what can you tell us about where Santa Monica Studios
I love that it's called Ragnarok,
this
just
one.
Like the Marvel
you know,
movie.
Like many of the fans, I'm personally really, really invested in the relationship between Kratos and Atreus.
Mm-mm-mm.
We got to see in the trailer that there's some real tension brewing between them as Ragnarok approaches. So
I
can't wait for players to see how that relationship between them evolves. And you gotta trust me when I say that Santa Monica Studio have prepared quite a few twists and
Hi,
turns
Will,
for players
Will
as
Poa.
They set up the finale of the Norse saga in God
oh,
of War Ragnarok.
We're gonna get an update on God of War Ragnarok from Santa
You're
Monica.
You're right, that
Studio
was kind of short.
But
was
before
that
you
it?
Go, Herman, I wanted to get your take on Horizon Forbidden West. Now, we've learned that this one is coming out in February. I am sure that by this point you have played it. So, what has jumped out to you? What can you tell us about the game?
I've had a chance to play the game on PS4 and PS5, and it looks great on both. For PS5, the level of detail on the Aloy, her kids, her lighting, it's just exceptional. Even more amazing because the environment.
Is it just
so
me that I don't think it looks
from the ruins
that
of San
great? Like,
to those new underwater
it's
areas,
good. Oh, underwater levels, because that's what everyone fucking
and it
wants.
It's really fast because of the SSD.
I don't
Plus,
know.
The combat in the game offers so much variety.
I don't think it's that good.
Player choice. There's so many cool weapons and tools, and when you combine these together, that comes in really handy.
Link already did it, you know.
The new machines.
It's just Breath of the Wild with extra steps.
The haptic feedback on the controller,
and more lens flares. Look how many lens flares there are, honestly, for no reason.
And the other ammo.
You know, feels like I'm watching
Gorilla,
the new Star Trek movies.
So well. I'm super proud of them.
Oh,
they're creating something
too bright.
Incredibly special. I just
am I old or is that too bright?
Aloy's adventure in their hands.
Thanks for the update, Herman. We're joined
Thanks,
by
Herman.
Eric and Corey from Santa Monica Studio. And I wanted to check in with you two on the big announce we saw just a few minutes ago. God of
Guy
War
in the middle
Ragnarok.
Has a weird shaped head.
Got our first big look at it.
A big,
and actually, Eric, I wanted to start
forehead.
With you.
That's a
You've
five
been
head.
Involved with every single God of War, including 2018's God of War. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct, Sid. I've been with the studio since 2004.
Yes, Legree. I know that Breath of the Wild came out after Horizon Zero Dawn.
And,
thank you for mansplaining that. Really appreciate
it.
Hey,
do you want to direct this one? And so,
excuse me.
That's what I'm doing. I'm directing God of War Ragnarok. Or
I think I've got a hernia.
Never heard of it. So
maybe that's why I'm not feeling so good. Every time
so
I eat or drink anything, I do those little
God of War Ragnarok.
Like big intakes of breath.
It's always been a tradition here at Santa Monica
something
to
wrong with
change
me.
The directors across the games. You know, we've had really
not
good success with that. Corey's been the only
Should I go to the fucking doctor?
And rightfully so. He's pretty damn good at what he does. So that's kind of what it is.
The important thing for us is to be able to kind of get a fresh perspective each time. But also, you
Ed
know,
man's got a tattoo on his chest.
You're really exhausted at the
Show
end of finishing one of these
what
things.
What'd it do?
So you gotta con somebody else into doing it, like him.
So Eric, what is that?
So where are the women? Where are the women
sort of
in gaming, huh?
You as a creative. I mean,
female
I
developers.
Like, how do you see yourself leaving your fingerprints on God of War Ragnarok?
That's kind of the designer in me wants to answer one way, but
is it their office? Wow, imagine working there.
You have to learn how to jettison your own. A profession when you switch over to the director's role, which I'm sure Corey
I doubt
can,
this is live.
Understand.
This is pre-recorded for sure.
On God of War 2, and we kind of had to throw it all out, except for that sneaky backflip that Kratos has never done again that we left in. That's the perk of being the director, I guess. But you know, from my point of view, like we want to tell a very heartfelt and epic story, as you know, father and son go on a journey. And
father and son, the work's
on
never done.
To stuff and letting go of things.
Cats
you know,
in the cradle and the silver spoon.
That we all deal with.
Little boy and, blue and the man
kind
of the moon.
We want to arrive at that by taking like slices of life or
Ew.
Family, you know, drama, if you will, and kind of.
Oh my God, drama bomb!
Norse backdrop.
Okay, that's
and,
cool.
You know, end,
I hope you can pat the dogs.
Very,
that's all I'm saying.
You know, surprising yet inevitable, based on
my
all those
cats
things,
being naughty.
It's,
Oi!
It's kinda, you know, I'm
Oi!
From the Midwest, so like just slice
Get
of life,
off.
Very common,
Get off, silly.
Just as interesting as big
you know
world
off.
Events, and so
Get
we try
off,
to collide
silly.
Those things together.
You're naughty.
You know,
yes.
An experience that's very
naughty
worthy of God of War name.
So naughty.
So with the game officially being called God of War.
Mama's trying to like.
I guess it doesn't take a genius to think that
the
perhaps
money.
Ragnarok factors into this game in some manner. Can you confirm that, Eric?
Yeah, I mean you can't. Call
I'm glad I remember that
Ragnarok
I made this controller just in time.
Happen in the game, so you know it's going to happen. We're going to cap off the Norse series with it, and I think Chris Judge said it best in the announce trailer last year. Prepare yourselves.
Okay, my cat
the
wants
last
attention.
Game ended with a teaser of sorts for Thor, and I just got to know, was that Thor's voice we heard in the trailer just a few minutes ago?
No,
that
it was his
definitely
mom's.
Thor's voice that we heard in the trailer. Thor is being played by Ryan
Thanks,
Hurst.
Thanks, Lotosi Knight.
But you might know him from.
It's gonna be a real
Sons
chill stream. We're not gonna do that much.
Favorite characters ever.
I'm gonna ease myself back in.
Delighted to have him come
Lube it up,
God
ease it on
Sandbox
home.
And his take on Thor and our take visually on Thor are very different than the hunky Australian you might know. You know, he's much closer to the Norse mythology version.
Well, maybe we want a hunky
burly,
Australian. Do you ever think of that?
Child, red hair. You know, left-handed, just a little off kilter than the Thor that a lot of people know right now. So I can't wait for people to.
But everyone loves that
that
Thor. So consider
we also
that.
We the name Odin in tonight's trailer. So I imagine if we're going to experience Ragnarok, Odin's going to have to play a pretty big role here, right?
Definitely. I mean, Odin is the all-father of all the realms.
Why the hell did I have to learn about Christian mythology? Why couldn't I learn about this sort of stuff? Norse mythology. It's a hell of a lot more interesting. They got way more hunky gods.
You may know him as Toby from the West Wing.
You know, as in more than one.
We never thought was going to happen. It was like kind of a shot in the dark. That would be nice. He got back to us and we walked him around the mocap volume and he was just like, I've never done anything like this before. Let's do it.
Oh, I have Crash. I could probably play some Crash.
I can't wait for people to
experience. But I don't think I have it downloaded.
So that's not very useful. He's like a old man who's just kind of busy with his own things and doing whatever he wants. And he doesn't live in a castle or anything like that. So it's again, a different take, kind of what we do. We just
my cat just jumped on my lap.
Curveball it a little bit and, make it special.
Hello.
We also saw a couple of new characters tonight. So what can you tell us about them?
Are you talking about the little squid? Oh no, you're talking about Tyr, the big guy.
He's who the fuck do you mean?
The Norse God of War. And Kratos and Atreus have finally found him. We talked a lot about him in 2018. So
he's so huge. Oh my god.
Might as well show him to the people. And then the last character we saw at the trailer, with the little wink and smile from Angar Boda. She's one of the last remaining giants, and her story is pretty amazing and how it fits into the world of God of War. Tyr is being played by Ben Prendergast, who's been completely absorbed in the role, even though he is not a giant as Tyr is. And then Angar Boda is being played by Leia De Leon Hayes, who's a complete treasure on set. She's been amazing. Watching her chemistry with the other characters has been amazing. And she's one of the last giants that's living. So we have those characters and a few more.
I love that.
A lot of different monsters.
Platypus Dragon. That's
so many
pretty
talented
dope.
People at the studio building this trailer.
You know what
together.
They should actually remake? Shadow of the Colossus. Can you imagine how amazing that would be on PS5? It's pretty amazing on PS2. Like, it used all the in-game graphics. And you could literally climb on these giant behemoths. And, like, all the textures were beautiful and could load. Man, please put on PS5. But, like, remake the game so it's even more epic. Not just a reskin or something.
Thank you very much.
Now, Corey, we haven't heard a whole lot out of you here tonight. So now that we know you're not directing God of War Ragnarok, I was hoping maybe you could give us a little clue about what you may or may not be working on next.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? You'd like me to just spill the beans and tell you everything that's going on right now. We're actually doing a bunch of stuff. It's really exciting, all the things that we're doing, and you're tempted to know what is this. But I don't really have anything I can talk about right now specifically, mostly because we're really focused on God of War Ragnarok, that I am incredibly excited that I finally understand that that's what everyone
Hi,
was
Mr.
saying.
Hi, Mr. Zerang. You could hear the purring? Holy shit. I have to remind myself never to fart on stream because you'll hear it for sure then. he's a pretty loud purrer, I guess.
All right. Well, thank you, Corey. And thank you, Eric. And next up, we have Ryan Treadwell. He's the lead producer.
He looks just how Ryan Treadwell should look.
Just a little while ago, we got the announcement of a remake.
Thank you, Nick.
Knights of the Old
Up next.
So, Ryan, I guess my question is, is this like a remaster of the original game, or what's going on here?
It's so much more, Sid. This is a complete remake of this beloved Star Wars story.
Ooh.
For Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic remake, we are rebuilding from the ground up.
We didn't see this one.
While maintaining that integrity of story and character from the original.
So Ryan, how much of a remake are we talking about here? I mean, is this updating some graphics, adding some higher resolution?
I'm not
modes?
A Star Wars fan, I'm so
you
sorry.
You know, the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is a true classic and one of our favorite Star Wars stories ever. We want to honor that original story and make it as impactful for players today. In terms of the visuals, we have an opportunity to present this story with a much higher level of fidelity than was possible in the past.
You can play this on your phone? What?
Being authentic
really?
To what players loved about that original game.
I've never
so
played a mobile game.
From bringing classic Star Wars games.
Because I'm not a fucking plebeian.
But this is a much bigger project than anything the studio's tackled before. So what can you tell me about the team behind the game?
KOTOR.
You're absolutely
KOTOR?
Right. While Aspyr has enjoyed a great relationship with Lucasfilm Games through our work bringing classic Star Wars games to new audiences on modern platforms, this project is on a completely different level to anything we have done before. That's why we knew we had
you guys should see
the
people in the comments now, because this is live on YouTube. Everyone's doing like the snoring emojis. They're like, this is boring. Why the fuck we want to hear these guys talk about the games?
People are so terrible, aren't they?
Yawn.
Of course,
some person says yawn. It's all the snoring emojis. That's so funny.
Together we couldn't
nothing like entitled nerd rage, you know. Show you in this the is a certain brand of entitlement. Of course, I love
Star it. Wars fans too. One of the nice parts about building a team to make a big Star Wars game is the ability to instantly bond with all of the new people over your favorite aspects of Star Wars. We all have different Star Wars memorabilia behind us and everything.
So tell me, what is exclusive on Xbox? I've never had an Xbox. Ryan.
Very exciting stuff, and I'm definitely dying to see more of that one.
I've always been PlayStation.
It'll be some time before we're ready to show
things
more,
were, you know,
we're very excited
exclusive
about
on PlayStation. Makes me happy.
All right, and that's
I
it
feel
for
like
our
Xbox
show.
You get for,
you can catch up on all the big news on PlayStation.blog and check out all the trailers from tonight's PlayStation Showcase on YouTube. Thanks for watching.
I would like to do that. Maybe I should do that. Well then. And that's it, I think. Amazing. Love it, love it. PlayStation, be the game. What's up, gamers? What's up, gamers? Unless there's any other trailers you want to watch, but I think that might have been fucking it. My bad. I didn't plan this through. I was just excited and I couldn't sleep. So here we are. You said you have an Xbox and everything that is on Xbox is on PC. Well, yeah, that's true. Because they're both Microsoft, huh? Yeah, they didn't think that one through, did they? And I think that's why PCs, people were so like PC master race with it. Because they're like, I don't even need an Xbox because I could just hook up my Xbox controller to my PC. So yeah, when you think about it, Xbox is kind of a waste of time. Kind of. Yeah, because if you don't even need the console to play the fucking game, why would you get one? You can get the controller, plug it into your goddamn PC, download the game on Steam or wherever the fuck you find it. Good to go, right? You like my controller? I designed it myself. Here we go. Haha. You like? I was gonna go with pink or purple, however, it kind of didn't show up against my outfit very well. So I thought, yeah, I know, Xbox controller, right? because I'm fake, right? Fake ass geek girl. I lied. I hoped you wouldn't notice that it wasn't a PlayStation controller. But y'all too observant, you know? Y'all too observant for your own goddamn good. Yeah, you know? This hoodie ain't even Adidas, bro. Can't afford it. Can't afford me some Adidas. Adidas swag. Slav swag. Hello, Fengu Chiha. Nice to meet you. Anyong. I like your name, TNT Kaboomski. Sounds Jewish but explosive. I like it. Wait, Luke's lightsaber was green. Huh? Since when? Not that I would know. Because I wouldn't. I lie. I wouldn't. I put this away. I bring out the one that I want, which is introducing, if it doesn't fucking crash my computer. Oh, she's chugging. Oh, she's chugging. Here we go. My baby girl. I like very much. I got a stuffy. I got a plushie. Ain't she cute? Ain't she cute? And she moves. Oh, she move. Oh, baby. And she groove. I go crazy because she look like the flower, but she sting like the bee. A cute. I know that. Fucking cute, right?
I got two. I got one in the back over there. Make it a merch item. Bish. No one wanted a Momo plushie back in the day when Ule was trying to organize them to get them made. People were like, nah. Too hard to make anyway. You have to do sort of, you know, pre-orders and shit. Ain't no room for that. Oh my god, I forgot about these things. Hang on, yeah, you want some head pat for Momo? Sure. Here we go. She gets the head pats too. I might get jealous. I might get jealous she's getting the head pats and I'm not. That's not fair. But thank you. Thank you for playing Streamloot's card. I forgot about them. If you play the kawaii one, I might have a new surprise for you as well. Kind of showing off my wares right now. Because although I haven't been streaming, I have been working on stuff. I have. I'm not lazy. I'm just depressed as fuck. And not feeling well. I also had my first COVID shot, so that might have something to do with it. I don't know. I just ain't felt that good. The kawaii. Kawaii. That awful Avril Lavigne song. I know you know it. I know. Did you just put a peepee on my face? Thanks for the peepee. The kawaii. No one has the kawaii card? Feels bad, man. Feels bad. That's bad, I'm calling. That's bad, I'm calling. Ayo. I gotta change my, like, stream. Oh no, you do! Back. Alright, I gotta get rid of all this shit first. Alright. Let me lay something fresh on ya. I don't know if you've seen these before, but we'll see. Alright. I don't know if you're ready for this cuteness, though.
Thank you for playing the kawaii card. I'm not very good at this voice for very long, but I really appreciate it. Yeah. Hi, Rice Hamster. I'm currently like murdering my thirsty because somebody played a kawaii Streamloot's card. And now I'm forced to be kawaii dashana. Rice Hamster is a, Moshi sibling. Yeah. Very cute. You should check out their channel. Tell me, was the kawaii card worth it? Did I do a good job?
Ow. Oh. Now I just look like I'm scheming. Wait. Oh, really? You, got some feet? Got some feet under those socks? I'll put these away. Oh wait, I gotta unlock them. They're attached to my body. And none the fun way neither. A strap on, if you will. If we're going by South Park rules, then yes. Yes. Oh man, Leo Greer had both your COVID shots. Good man. I only had my first one. It was fine. I'm just very scared of needles, but I'm actually more afraid of the dentist, so... I have to do that. What the hey? Kixile. Kixile was not about to let anybody dethrone them. Thank you very much. You get... Just for that, you get a peace sign, alright? And not just because I want to show this off or nothing. Peace. Wow, indeed. Wow. Yep. Kickstar said, Spud Kill 2, get on my fucking level, bro. Thank you very much. Thank you. What's G-O-W, Oli Colly Wally? You'll have to not abbreviate. I'm a bit special. Right, Kixile? Because I'm so old, I don't have the energy for streaming that these youngins do. I did for maybe a month or two, and then I was like, I just want to lay on the couch and watch Netflix. There's some Rick and Morty on. Sex Education's coming out next week. Like, I got stuff to do, you know? Places to be, people to do. Wait. Yeah, places to be and people to do up the butt. Oh boy. You're right. Oh my god. Local gas. I guess you are my little pog champ. And so is Kickstyle and Spudkill. My poggers. Totally poggers, pog champ. Biatch. Damn, I live like this? Well, yes. Yes, I do, in fact. Dr. Sirius, you really like it when I insult you, don't you? You still want the insult. Okay. Do you fucking sleep, Dr. Sirius? Because I ain't slept in over 30 hours or more. I'm thinking like 3 days. I'm streaming at a time I'm not even normally awake. And here you are. Here you fucking are. Do you just wait? Does your life like revolve around me? You just wait for me to fucking come online. I bet you know exactly how many days it's been since I last streamed. Because that is the last time that you touched your wee wee. Yep. How'd I do? Was that a good insult? Did I do good? Did I make assumptions about your life that were incorrect and made me very uncomfortable? I'm sure. But Thanatos, my body, will only hate me if I attempt to do the Jacko challenge. It does not want to cooperate. Plus, I'll probably split my pants. Maybe that's the reason I haven't been on much. Because I fucking split my pants. Oh wait, I have to change to just chatting. Just chatting and memes. And memes. And I have to... Oh, I didn't put tags on because I'm an idiot. How are people supposed to find me if I don't even tag my stream? Idiot. I'm a goddamn idiot. Oh, Mordecai. Thank you for 100 biddies. And no. I really want... I've only been streaming for not even an hour, so you haven't missed nothing. You ain't missed nothing yet. Oh god, I'm just remembering how much Healy's to Escape Feelies donates. I see up the top. There are 200 big ones. Oh boy. If I stream at like 7 a.m, maybe they won't find me. This is my grand master plan. For sure. Yes, please. If you got a lovely subby from Kixile, please thank them. Because now you can use dope-ass emotes. I know you love it. I know you do. Hi, Sora Kasai. Another VTuber? Oh my god. I love. Put up a goal bar? Well, I don't know if I have a goal. There is another tea set I have my eye on. But it's very expensive. And I don't know if I feel right for charging people for my tea addiction. Oh, I get the hip pad too. Thank you. So it's not just the Momo blush. Yay.
I get the hip pad. I get the hip pad. Hip pad for me.
Just know if I had my model, I'd totally be streaming as Karen right now. For fuck's sake.
Depression.
What? Don't say just a PND tuber. PND tubers are dope. You are where VTubing came from. I'm talking about roots. Talking about roots. You wanna yeet my face, my hand off my head? That's mean. Why would you do that? I'm having a good time. How much did the model and rigging cost? Oh god. Well, Remains to be seen for the second one, I can tell you that. All you see here, because I'm not a full body, by the way, I'll show you where. This is why I can't give you feet pics.
I missed your first stream. Work's been knocking me tired. Also, look. After I saw the Mountain Dew clip, I found out apparently Mountain Dew makes pineapple soda.
I have no feet.
New gamer juice acquired Kappa.
I have no feet. And so, that's all I could afford. I couldn't afford a full body because, you know, I live in a basement. But yeah. No feet, no legs. But you know, my Karen model probably will. I had a cool idea for it actually. So, you know how most models just stand here like this? I thought, what about my Karen one? I'm sitting down and my feet is up, like cross-legged on a gaming chair or some shit. Why do I have to be standing up? I don't want to stand up when I'm streaming. Fuck my back. But yeah, I just thought, why not? Why can't I just be a bit more creative with it? Wow, Ollie Collie, you can't tell if this is 2D or 3D? That's amazing. That just proves how amazing the Moshi team were to help me be born. Oh, Dr. Sirius, how sweet. You got Mordecai gift sub. Oh, you're gonna be so sweet. Well, there's currently a huge wait for my next 2D model, so I'm kind of looking for a 3D model, but I don't know. Lots more money than I want to spend, probably. Oh my god, Hype Train is close again.
I really love the model. I am hoping to get one in October.
I hope you do. I hope you do, PB and Jebby. Why don't you try the some of the pre-made ones first? Excuse me. They're pretty fun. Yeah. And I'll never judge somebody who has one either. Because it's all about the fun. That's what I think. Yeah, Rice Hamster has a very cute model too. Angel. Baby, you the angel. Rice Hamster's very nice. If I knew how to do shout out, I would do so. But I don't. I don't think I had that set up. But yeah, I'm 2D, technically. Even though you couldn't really tell, right? It's pretty good. If I zoom in, my head turns. I'm not 3D. Cool, right? Yeah. It's amazing. It's amazing what you can do with technology these days. Oh, Shadow Wolf, thank you for the 10 packs again. Best customer. Oh, Dive's animation in me? You mean this? You mean this? I guess in that I have feet, right? I totally have feet in that. You weirdos. Fucking weirdos. Tiny feet, yeah. Oh, Dr. Sirius, you're so sweet. Oh, see, Mordecai, there are people who care about you. Obviously Dr. Sirius does. Maybe I do too. You never know. Maybe I'm a tsundere. You'll never know my true feelings. But if I'm doing all right, and if I can get up in the morning, you can too. Gun button it. Sora Kasai, why nervous? I'm the one performing, I'm fucking nervous. Oh, Cheryl. I have to come close for this. All right. Ready? Ah-da-da. Anna, Anna. That was a good one. I surprised myself. That was a good one. Oh, I'm creamy down there. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness me. Not sleeping has made my voice super gravelly and sexy. I like to pretend. Totally. How was that? Was it good for you? Because it was good for me. What? Sorry, Kasai. I'm just a fucking 32-year-old bitch on YouTube and stream and stuff. I ain't done shit with my life. This is my quote-unquote job. Being streamer. I'm a good streamer. Wait, Shadow Wolf shapes? Do you mean... You mean the crackers? Like the fucking cheddar crackers? That I love those. Who here ordered T2? Oh, someone here ordered T2T. T2. Oh, that's alright, Renkai. I wasn't sure about it, but meh. Here we are, anyway. The very short-ass PlayStation trailer. I wanted to exit out pretty quick because I wasn't sure if I was going to play a fucking ad or something showing my suburb. Because in my old days, I used to stream under a different name. And I fucking doxed myself, eh? I had Spotify on and a fucking ad came up. And it was like, oh, and it mentioned my exact suburb. Because I guess their geo-tracking's that good that they're like, oh yeah, you'll totally want your lawns mowed in this suburb you live in. And I was like, well, everybody heard that. Fantastic. Fantastic. So now I'm super paranoid. I always stream with a VPN. Oh, but like a specific VPN. I hope it helps anyway, but you never know. YouTube can be sneaky. Sometimes they know you're using a fucking VPN and then they just won't let you play anything. It's dumb. But sometimes you get doxxed in the weirdest ways. Like, how the hell was I meant to account for that? I didn't even think of that. Like, you just shaming me for being povo as fuck and poor and not being able to pay for Spotify Premium $11.99 a month. My $11.99 a month goes towards Netflix, thank you very much. Fucking Spotify. Head ass. Hell nah. Yeah, no. I would totally, like, brand rip NordVPN or some of the other ones. I'm just waiting. I really want to be sponsored by someone. I want to be a brand ambassador and rip something. I want something. Something. Gimme. I'll be the G Fuel bitch. I don't know. G Fuel seems to be the one everyone's with. I'll put your logo on my outfit. I don't give a fuck. I want to be that bitch that looks like a Gran Turismo car. I want you to be like, yes, they own my body and soul. They give me the monies. There you go. Zyrod, I think you're thinking of someone else. Please read the rules. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Gamma Sups. What the hell is Gamma Sups? Sounds stupid. Sups, as in you sip them? The Raid Shadow Legends. I never played that before. No. Rice Hamster, are you going? I remember Rice Hamster. I gave you like legendary. You've got the sword of the mod. That's what you got. Oh, same thing as G Fuel. Okay. I mean, I had no idea it was such a big business to sell sugary, carbo-loaded drinks to nerds. But apparently, here we are. And if there's a girl with big booba holding it and drinking it on stream, people are like, I want that inside me because it was inside her hot girl guts. Yes. What's my favorite game series? A series? That's a bit hard. I'll probably Pokemon. Yeah. Remember, I played a Pokemon Nuzlocke for the very first time on stream. It was awesome, but long, but awesome at the same time. Mountain Dew? I want to try this pineapple one now. I'm gonna look it up. Can you even get it in New Zealand? Pineapple Mountain Dew. Probably get it at Costco. You can totally get it. Maui Burst. I didn't even know there was different flavored Mountain Dew. It's permanent soda flavor. What? burst. Oh, now I have to try it. I haven't had a Mountain Dew since I went to fucking Pizza Hut for children's birthday parties back in the day. Or Cobb & Co. Man, what? Am I a fan of sushi? Yes, I had sushi just today. I got Uber Eats. I did. I'm not turning a blade. Nah, I won't be playing no games today. Sorry. Don't feel like it. Yeah, nice. Yeah, so I'm gonna try. Actually, I had katsu chicken curry today. It was nice. I know that there's like, there was some kind of red one. There was some red Mountain Dew that I saw all the people online trying, but I never got to try it. Mountain Dew sucks. Vanilla Coke is where it's at. Oh, I love Vanilla Coke. And now they finally made it sugar-free, so I'm just like, gimme. I got so much in my fridge. It's not funny. Makes me poop, though. But it's good. It's a good poop. Orange Vanilla Coke? Eh. Why both at the same time? I would totally have a blood orange one, just to be extra pretentious. Lemon Coke was fun. Lemon Coke was great. Oh yeah, you like my background? I got a fidget spinner and stuff. But you know what? In a couple more weeks, I'm gonna be taking all that shit off my wall back there. It's gonna be just a blank wall. And then, oh yes, then, I'm going to be putting graffiti on it by you guys. So if anybody has not gone on my YouTube or on my Twitter, I released a video where I said, hey, if you guys wanna like make me some street art, it doesn't have to be of me even, it can be anything you want, but it has to be made specifically for my wall in like a spray painted style, as you can see back there. And, excuse me, I will use my ultra awesome tagging powers and I will recreate it on my back wall. So you'll be able to see during stream, yay, you'll be able to see your artwork on my wall. So that'd be cool, right? Yeah. If you can't draw, you can always commission someone to draw something for you. Like, $5 can go a long way on Fiverr. But yeah, it's just optional. Just fun. Something fun. I got a really cool one yesterday. I was like, oh. I felt bad. I was like, I thought everyone was going to do stuff like this. Like, just... well, not crappy drawings, but you know, like... just in this style, like someone tagged on a wall in 5 seconds. But no, people have been sending me some really awesome stuff and I'm like, wow, the effort, why? It's meant to be silly. I thank them though. Very nice. Can you commission me to draw? Nah, I'm too busy. Nah, I have too much to do. Too much Netflix to watch. But yeah, you can get it in by October 1st, please. Please. Can do. 30 euros? Euros are... I'm going to tell you how much dollary dues, New Zealand dollary dues will be in euros. So euro to NZD. Let me tell you. Okay, 1 euro. 1 euro is equal to $1.66 in New Zealand. So if I got paid 30 euros... I'd be making $50. So I would be a very happy chappy. Extremely. Euros go far. Euros are amazing. I would love to be paid. I'd love to be paid in euros. Absolutely. Have I thought of doing another art stream? I mean, I kind of gone off drawing lately, if I'm honest with you. I get very nervous. I get extremely nervous drawing on stream. I don't know why. I think it's partly you have to talk and like, you know, interact with people. It's very distracting. So I would say on nights where I don't feel like talking much, I'm gonna go Karen mode, but I can't go Karen mode for a couple more months until my model is made. But that is a plan. Like if I don't feel well, I wanna switch to Karen mode. I wanna not have my makeup on, no costume. I'll just sit there. And you can just watch me draw. And there won't be that much talking. I mean, the occasional, yeah. But it'll be very chill, relaxing. We'll just vibe.
and I won't do shit. I just think that'd be nice. Yeah. And then you get to see more of my beautiful face in the morning. Yeah, I think it sounds nice. And we can vibe, have some music on, you know. Can you play copyright music on stream? I see people doing it and I'm like, but I've heard you can get banned for that. So I don't know. Put up the money, Goba. I'm all right. I don't need money. I don't. I'm fine. I'm fine. I don't do this for the money anyway. I just do it as like stress relief for myself. And just to have a bit of social interaction. Because we're in lockdown right now in New Zealand, by the way. I can't leave. I'm stuck here. It's my grandma's birthday the other day. I couldn't even go see her. Poor dear. That's why I'm sad. No, Leagre, you weren't rude. No, it's nice. I might put it up. I don't know. I kind of do want that tea set. I'd like to show you a picture of it, actually. Let me find a picture. I have one. I have a picture. Let's see. Haha, here it is. Desktop. Put that there. Why when you save shit on Twitter does it go like JPEG medium? It annoys me so much. I can't really... I'll fucking dox myself trying to like put a picture on screen, won't I? Maybe. Maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I shouldn't. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I want to show you. Maybe I can find a photo and link it to you. Okay. Royal tea set. And it's... Is it Royal Albert? Yes. Yes, it's Royal Albert. Which is a fucking hoity-toity, violently British, I should say. But if you see the price of it, you're gonna balk. So this... Well, that's an Australian site. I don't need that. I don't need that. That's not the right one. But you're right. I don't want to dox myself, even though I found a picture. I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, this link's no good to me because it's in Australia, but there you go. That is the one that I want so badly. Because I actually have a teacup and saucer with this exact design on it. And I love it. I love it so much. I'll be using it in future streams because my tea room is almost finished. Spoilers. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. We're going to have a new location. My mom has let me stream upstairs for my tea breaks. But the tea room's not quite finished. So we'll see. It's not tacky. What are you talking about? It's Royal Albert, bro. It's so legit. What are you talking about? Oh. Metadata. I mean, it's not my picture, so it's fine. I just found it online. Yeah. But don't you only have metadata if you have location services activated? Which, who the fuck has location on their phone these days? Hell no. My Snapchat is locked the fuck down. Like, I hate all that geolocation shit. It's no one's business where you are. My friend was like, oh my god, my like boyfriend wants to know where I am at all times. So he made me have the Find My Fam app and it alerts me whenever he checks it, and he checks it like 8 times a day. It's like, wow, okay. So this is what we're resorting to, like stalking our partners. Awesome. So creepy, right? I can't believe people do that. How do you not trust your partner? It's like, okay, it's locked down. Where's she gonna fucking be? Sounds like shit my ex-husband would do if he knew how to work technology like that. God.
2020 Invisible Man shit. I love it. Is it Granny's tea set? Well, I am 32 TNT Kaboomski. I'm old, man. I love this shit. I love the girly stuff. Do I have any tall girlfriends? I don't have no girlfriends at all. What are you talking about? Girlfriends are for people who have lives. Mm-mm. Lives or wives. Young and beautiful. Oh, thank you. Thank you. If I keep my waist trim, then maybe I'll look more youthful. I certainly look more youthful than some of my friends. I saw one of my old friends, my old high school friends on Facebook yesterday. I was like, holy shit. I'm not to be a bitch, but she had so many wrinkles. I was like, girl, you're 32. You got more wrinkles than my grandmama. It was crazy. Is Pixie my friend? Yeah, hell yeah. I love Pixie. She's lewd as fuck, but I love her. Amazing person. You're 5'6", is that tall for a woman? No, that's average, I think. Most people are 5'9 these days, it seems. You can't really talk about height anymore because men get offended. I would just assume every man is 6 feet. There you go. Permanent eye bags, yeah, I feel. Not even my makeup can hide those babies. There you go, 5'9". 5'9". 5'9's a good height. I reckon that's like the perfect height. Because you're tall, but you're not a freak. Doesn't matter. Height doesn't matter anyway. I'll tell you something. My granny is so funny. I once told her, I was like, yeah, granny, like, I don't think I would ever date someone who was like shorter than me. And she looks at me and she goes, oh, Karen, it's all the same lying down, isn't it? I was like, granny! Granny? What the fuck? It's all the same lying down, she said. She said that. Dirty old bag. Oh, man. Oh, I love my granny. I'm so sad I didn't get to see her on her birthday. I'm sure she had much more words of wisdom for me. I remember this time. We got one of those joke emails that used to go around, you know, before Gmail was a thing. And we got this dirty one where there was a Scotsman sitting on a hill and he was wearing a kilt and he had no underwear on underneath, of course. And the caption was, "The Loch Ness Monster is real." And he had the biggest peepee I have ever seen in my life. This was huge. And my granny looked over, it was me and my auntie. She looked over our shoulder at this picture. And she goes, oh, I've seen bigger. Granny! I want to be like her when I'm older. Holy crap, she's so funny. My granny has lived. She's lived her life. It's so natural too. Like, she didn't laugh. So I was there like, ha! Wait. Yo, serious? Granny, like, are you telling jokes or... Considering she got pregnant at 18, I fucking hope not. She meant she'd seen a bigger dick than the Scotsman Loch Ness Monster. My granny was a Chad before Chads were Chads. I miss her so much, you guys. I miss my granny. Oh. Part of the reason I want the tea set is because I wanted to drink tea with her on her birthday. There's a reason I like tea and it's because of my granny. Fucking COVID, right? Ugh. Sucks. But I have a good tea collection now, so I'll be able to bring her some new ones she hasn't tried yet. So that's good. How do I take my tea? I snort it up my nose. No, I like it. Milk and honey, bitch. Black tea with milk and honey. Or I do like a lemon and honey with no milk. I don't really like boba tea all that much. It's okay, but it's very, very sweet. Yeah, Leo Gree, I mean, it's a bit of a tricky one because they're not bad people, these boomers and older, but they are very old-fashioned. And they don't really know what all these newfangled things are because, oh, back in my day, we never heard of this shit, you know. So they think it's all made up or they just reject it. So really, it's kind of better off not telling your grandparents if you know that they're not going to be very accepting. Like, I ain't told my granny I'm divorced yet, or that I'm going to be. She doesn't need to know. She's very traditional. She's a Korean lady, so yeah. Better off not telling her I'm divorced at 32. Because I'm past my prime, according to, you know, fucking Korean law. So I'm never going to find someone else who would want to marry me. I'm 32. Female. I hit the wall, bro. I'm a doom and gloomer. I'm a gloomer, I would say. I have a question about boba tea. Why the... Aww. You're too sweet. So with boba tea, why do they call it toppings when that shit is on the bottom? You know when you order the tea and they go, what toppings do you want? And I'm like, what do you mean toppings? Don't you mean bottomings? The toppings are useless if they're on the top, right? They're meant to sink down to the bottom, so why are they called toppings? Why? Tell me one good fucking reason. Lordy, lordy, loo. The world we live in, as they say. Yeah, Renkai, right? Right? It's a conspiracy, I tells ya. You'd marry me? Ah. That's nice, but I'm done with that shit. People suck. Why would I want to be tethered to someone permanently? Fuck no. No, never again. Yeah, it's like, how do you want your toppings? How do you want your boba? Oh, bottoming, please. How do you want your jelly? I like it when it's the bottom. I like it when the jelly knows its place. Yeah, I mean, Renkai, don't rush into marriage like I did. Just, be domestic and see if you can stand them first. Fucking live together. Live together first. That is my best advice that I can give. Nut. Polly? Nah. I'm jealous. I'm the jealous type. I could never do that Polly shit. Mm-mm. Power be to people that can, but man... You wouldn't want to see me. Plus, I think it's like, poly is great, but there's so many people who use it just to cheat. Especially, I've seen on Reddit heaps. There's like 18-year-old girls and they're like, yeah, so I'm with this 34-year-old guy and yeah, things are going pretty well. Like, he treats me really good, but he just said that he wanted to be like, us to be poly, but you know, he wants to sleep with all the women without telling me, but I'm not allowed to sleep with any men. No, it's just him that's gonna be poly. So I don't know, what do you guys think? Like, what should I do? Fucking leave him. I hate Reddit. drop it. No. Drop it and date someone else. Fuck, I am the jealous type, I admit it. Yep. If you're mine, you're mine. You know what I'm saying? I don't share. I don't share food. I share life advice. That's pretty much it. I don't share food. I don't share partners. I don't share shit.
I'm good enough that what's mine is mine and should be mine. Mine? It's called self-respect, bro. I know my worth. I know my fucking worth. And mine. It will be mine. Joey doesn't share food. Sharing is caring. Nah. Sharing is how you get diseases. Hey, that works in two ways. I love it. I'm so smart. I have such the quips, right? I think the poly relationships, when they do work, they're fucking magical. Everyone communicates. Everyone's on the same page. No one gets jealous. Full communication, like, beautiful, right? I do know one couple, a throuple, I should say, where that's very much the case. So, excuse me, it can work. But most of the time, people are just like, nah, I just want to, like, have a relationship and also have other people. I'll just say I'm poly. It's like, you weren't poly before, were you? Jesus. Hell no. And then, I had this guy once who was like, oh, but you would be poly, what'd he say? It was something like, but if you really trust the person, you should be able to like accept it. And I'm like, but being poly is like a sexuality though. So if I'm not poly, I'm not poly. You know what I'm saying? And he's like, no, but you're just saying that because you don't trust me. You know, you mustn't trust me. And like, if we had good communication, it'll be fine. It's like, no, bro, I'm not poly. That's it. He was like trying to say that, I don't know, I don't trust him or something, just because I wouldn't let him fuck around. It's like, you could be poly, that's fine, but I'm fucking not and I don't share. No, former boyfriend, unfortunately. Nah. He can go be poly with someone else who is poly, but I'm not. I get jealous. Mine. You have to understand it, bro. You just have to accept it when people say they are Dragon Hunter. There's plenty of things I don't understand, but that doesn't mean they're not true. Trust people's experiences. You can't go wrong. A lot of people don't understand asexuality either. But you should never tell someone that they're not ace when they try and explain it. Is this why you've been single for 6 years? What's wrong with that? Get to know yourself. I'm sure you're amazing. Nothing wrong with being single. Better to be single than be with someone who's shit for you. Someone who's terrible. Am I Demi Ace? Eh. I don't know what I am. All will be revealed. All will be revealed one day. I'll tell you when I figure it out. But for now, I don't want nothing to do with nobody. Back the fuck up. I'm still married. I gotta be divorced soon, so we'll see. That's right, Dragon Hunter. You should wait. Wait until you find somebody that you really like. Don't just be with someone because you're lonely or because you just don't want to be single. That's a really bad reason. There's a lot of people who, I can tell you my number one turn off for guys, if you like. So number one turn off is when a guy seems like mystified by you. He's like, wow, oh, you're my dream girl, wow. And then you see him saying the same shit to any woman that he meets, because he's just so desperate. And I'll tell you this right now, women in general, we want to feel like the number one. We want all of your attention, 100%. And if we see that you're talking to other women, nah, we'll never fuck with you again. Nah. So, one woman at a time, and make sure you really like her, you know what I'm saying? If you want relationships. If you just want to fuck around, it's cool. Just flirt with anybody. But if you're wanting a relationship, put all your energy into one person.
No, my turnoff is not desperation. I wouldn't say it's desperation. I would say when they treat women like we're all the same, you know, like anyone will do, any one of us will do. That's more what I'm getting at. Being desperate is fine, because a lot of people are. But if you're devoted, you know, if you're devoted, I find that very attractive, personally. No, I wouldn't say it's incel-y to go after lots of women like that. I think it's more... It's really hard for me to explain what I mean, but... Okay, for example, yeah, there was this guy back in high school I really liked, and he seemed to really like me too, you know? We would message all the time. And then I just saw him saying the same shit on, like, every other girl in our class's Facebook. You're gorgeous, like, oh my god, like, being simpy for multiple girls at the same time. And that made me feel very not special, you see. And I want to feel special. The whole, oh, treat her like a queen thing, it's so true. It's so true, though. You don't have to let me walk all over you, but you must know my worth. And if you don't know my worth, I'm not gonna fucks with you. Mm-mm. Nope. Yeah, yeah. Exaroid, you're so right. You're so right. They think being in a relationship will just make them happy, and it won't if it's not the right person. And if you don't really like them. So, if you're wanting to be with a girl, don't just be with a girl to be with a girl. It has to be the girl. The girl that you like.
I'm gonna be off, so it's trademark dad joke time.
Oh god,
what
no.
What do you call a pencil with two erasers? Pointless.
Gee, thanks, Dr. Sirius. Door is on your left. Happy Father's Day. Thanks, everybody. If you guys are leaving, thank you for coming anyway. Sorry we devolved into Tiger's personal relationship woes. I do enjoy the odd dad joke, but I don't really get puns sometimes. Yeah, as I was saying, if you see a girl and you think she's pretty, like, cool, but do you know anything about her? And can you not fucking breathe without her? Please. Find the one that you like. Not just because she's a girl, I like every girl that will talk to me or look at me. That's called putting them up on a pedestal. You don't need to do that. Excuse me. But Zaroid, trust me, you can be like that all you want. There'll be one girl one day who'll just knock you on your ass. She'll knock you on your ass and you will change everything for her. Because she'll be worth it. And you know. You'll know when that special click comes along and you're like, I can't live without them. I will change whatever I can to be with them, because being without them is pain. You know what I mean? So you have to be open to love, though, because yeah, if you close yourself off, it's never going to happen. But sometimes it can hit you like a sledgehammer. Your maiden heart. That's cute. My maiden heart. You make my maiden heart all flutter. Yeah, it must be hard to date these days. I don't know. I haven't dated in so long. It's like, I'm happy on my own. I don't need nobody. I'm living with my mom. My mom's cool. There's more to life than, yeah, that. But they say friendships are important. I don't have that many friends either. But the ones I do have are the good ones. Yes. The unfortunate things with guys is, you know, early on in their lives, they're so cute when it comes to relationships. Like all the, most of the teenage boys, you know, they love their girlfriends, and they'll just like buy them gifts, and they're just like, oh, I love my girlfriend. And they'll be with someone who just fucking rips their heart out so bad, some bitch, and he'll never get over it.
he'll spend most of his 20s being an absolute cunt bag because he's like, nope, no bitch is ever gonna run around on my heart ever again. So I'm just gonna be a douche because that's how she treated me. I've seen it time and time again, and he'll never be as sweet as he was if he was unfortunate enough to get his heart stomped on as a teenager. So sad, right? Yeah, my brother bought this, like, saved up all his money, bought his girlfriend, like, a little bracelet with a heart on it. Oh, it was so cute, you know? And, yeah, she violently dumped him, and he's been a dirtbag ever since. He's never got over it. Never. It's a cycle. It's the cycle of abuse. Excuse me. Ooh. It does happen, bro. And most women, I mean, we've all been around people who make us hate men. But we love them anyway. We love men at the same time. Wait, you have to pay for prom? That sucks. What do you have to pay for? That didn't make no sense. I do. I have a brother. Don't see him much, though. Excuse me. Is it true in American high schools that you, excuse me. And the proms and that, is it, like, shameful to not have a date? I've seen that in American movies, and I'm like, what? Me and my friends just all went. No one really cared if you had a date or not. Like, that wasn't really, like, a thing, you know? But when I see it, I'm like, oh, so they shame you when you don't have a date. That really sucks. What? Never went to prom? Fair. That's fair. We had a ball. They're called balls in New Zealand, not prom. But we didn't have prom, king or queen. High school in New Zealand's very different. We don't have pep rallies. We don't have American football. We don't have cheerleaders. We don't have varsity jackets. I don't know. We don't have much. You're just sort of there to learn. We all wear uniforms to high school. Yeah. Bowl. Bowls. That's a fun word. Bowls. Dude, yeah, college was the tits. I love college. People don't go if they don't have a date. What? But it's a big old party and you get to get dressed up. That's nuts. I totally go. Destroy. Alright. You asked for the Glock. I even forgot that I had this card. Let's see. I need to name these things better. Yes. There you go. Is that too big? Yes. Yes, it is. I need to add my sweater to it. Golden Gate King. I see you. I see you've come into my bedroom. Unannounced. Interrupted me. While I'm given sage advice to these lonely ass incels. You come in here thinking you all that hot shit. Saying, oh, I want your gun in my face. I'm sure you want many things of mine in your face. Well, you're not gonna get it. You can dream. You can give me your money. But I'm telling you right now. These thitties, they ain't never been in your mouth, baby boy. These mummy milkies, they're not for you. So you better fucking watch your step. Now go get me a cup of tea and apologize to all the nice incels in chat. Grab your red pill, shove it up your ass. Final warning. Oof. Was that good?
Did I scare you? Are you scared? Are you scared? Probably gonna get banned for saying incel. Oh well. You loved it. You're like, oh yes, my nipples. Rub them, tiger tongue. He loved it. I know you loved it. Oh God, why? Ah! Why? Breaking my balls, man. Breaking my balls here.
I worry, Gomen Nasai, that I...
I threatened you with my Glock. I forgot the fucking Japanese word for I'm sorry. It's Gomen Nasai, isn't it?
I'm sorry that I put a Glock in your face. Oh, well, Gomen Nasai. Gomen Nasai. Forgive me, onegai. Oh.
Help.
Yeah, what if you don't step off, cunt? It's gonna be your ass. On a silver fucking platter. You ever heard of the mongrel mob? They're a very dangerous New Zealand gang. They'll fuck you up, brah. We've got jackets. Your ass is grass and I'm gonna mow it. Mowe, mowe, kya! I'm not threatening you with a good time. I'm just straight up threatening you, brah. You're balding? Ew. Get away from me. Gross. Onegai! Mwah! Niko niko nyua! 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 Nyua!
I sound like Gangsta Fluttershy. Wait.
Oh, he's a bear. Yeah.
I don't think I can sound like Fluttershy. I don't know what to say. Oh wow, my voice sounds much clearer. Do you hear this? You banished all of the vocal fry out of my voice. Wow. It's because I have that loogie in my throat.
Yeah, well, Cole, in America, you got the war on drugs and all your troops went to Afghanistan for no fucking reason. So don't you lecture me about your tanks and missiles. It's not actually a good thing. You fuck nugget. Na 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 na. Cause we're war criminals. And we're gonna shove these nukes up your ass. Cause no one else is allowed to have them but us. Cause we're fucking hypocrites.
I just felt a laser pointer pointed at my house. I think I'm gonna get drone striked, my guys. If I die, I die knowing that I blitzed Americans and salted on you. Oh no. I smur. I'll try. Hang on.
I'll put up my fight gain. Here. Now we are here with racist ASMR. Because Americans think that they are a race of people. Like, it's not even correct. But you can't correct them. No, Andrew Dickerson. We don't have oil. We have the next best thing. Free healthcare. And like, no crime. Or guns.
have sheep. And they're really cute. But don't fuck them. You might regret it. Oh wait, I should totally hug my plushie. Here we go. Here's my sheep. Her name is Momo. She's very cute. She tastes like cotton candy. Delicious. No, Cole. You're not the biggest superpower. You're just the biggest jerks. And you have the biggest guns. But we have this thing called soft power. Where basically, we don't have many guns or weapons, but people really like us. So, if anyone ever wanted to attack us, you'd be the biggest cunts, and no one would be on your side. Everyone would hate you, and they would refuse to give you oil and shit from China. So, suck on that, biatch. I did it. Yeah, I did it. Yeah, I did it. Ha ha. Well, I don't have my ASMR microphone anymore. My mom was scared of it and she threw it out. She's like, Karen! Why you have this? I don't like the ears. She didn't like it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Here I'll, well... Might just be here for 10 more minutes or something. Cyan, hello. Sorry, impromptu stream. But I just noticed that, well, there was a PlayStation fucking, what's it called? Showcase. And I was like, I like PlayStation. I don't feel like playing games, but I'll fucking talk about games. So let's do it. That's right, Andrew Dickerson. If anybody attacked New Zealand, A, it's too far away from it for any missiles to hit it. But if we got attacked, everybody would rush to help us because everybody loves New Zealand. And we're so helpless. So helpless, Oni-chan. Can you please help us? And yeah, America would just swing their dick and obliterate anybody who fucked with us. I like this. My favorite PlayStation game is probably Abe's Odyssey. Yeah, I really like that game. A few weeks ago had our first COVID case. Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, we've had COVID, but we've had like 10 deaths or something. Still tragic, but yeah, we've got pretty good laws about it. We have hardly any COVID here. It's cool. Excuse me. Fanto, what are you talking about anuses for? This is a cuddly, nice stream, and you're talking about anuses. Also, RarePony291, I didn't see, but thank you very much for subscribing. I didn't tell you guys, but we were very close to a hype train before, but we missed it. I always forget to mention it, because I'm a derp, but it's okay. A Floridian? Floridian? Yeah, Abe's Odyssey got a remake in like 2018 or some shit. I played it, for sure. For sure. I mean, I'm a derp when I go like this. Everyone seems to love the smug face. I should have had on my body pillow, come to think of it. So yeah, if anybody doesn't know, I have a body pillow now. Wait. You have to see it properly. Okay. Watch my eyebrows. I have a body pillow now. A body pillow. Oh, wait. (laughs) I'm blinking like a goddamn Pixar character in Toy Story. But do you guys like the Momo? It's kind of janky, but I like because she's cute. Yeah. I got shit in the works, bro. I got stuff going on. Holding a ducky. Yeah, actually, if you've never tried a dakimakura, you don't even have to get a character on it if it creeps you out, but just having a long pillow to like spoon, so you put one leg over and one sort of underneath if you want, it's really good for your back. I'm so serious. I really like. Yeah. I mean, to me, it's just me with or without makeup, so that's like asking a cosplayer, hey, do you like get off to your pictures of yourself in cosplay? It's like, yes. Why, yes, I do. That's right, Leo Gree. You're your wife's ducky muck, right? That's so cute. Aww. Well, for anyone who doesn't want one, I mean, I might put them out as posters or something. Because they kind of work. If I put them together, maybe. Maybe. Let's fighting love. Let's fighting love. Did I hear somebody likes kisses? Who here likes the kisses? I give you a kiss. I give you a little kiss. Give little kiss. You like the kiss? You want little kiss? I'm glad you liked. Thank you. I totally can't wait to get my ASMR microphone back from my mom. You're blushing. Kiki. I want photos of people who get my dakimakura. I was so excited. I hope they look good. I really hope they do. I didn't get sent a sample, fucking cheapskates. Thank you, Shadow Wolf, for that. Stella, absolutely Stella. I like it because it's quite gentle. It's a very gentle, soulful mole. You can probably send them me on Twitter. I'm most active there, actually. I think Nocturnal Blade is probably just straight up narcissism. You know, there's totally people who like look at themselves in the mirror while doing stuff. And to me, I'm just like, why? Really? You have to have a mental problem to do that, surely. Like occasionally you'll look in the mirror and be like, yeah, I'm looking good today. But that should be as far as it fucking goes. There's confidence. And it is a straight up narcissism and vanity and shit.
Feel free to say no, but can you sing happy birthday for my wife?
Of course I can, Leo Griff. What is their name? Their name, her name, whatever. What's their name? I will do. When am I gonna get a Tiger Town Bali pillow? I don't know. They're expensive. I didn't get sent a sample, so I'm probably never gonna have one. Sucks, man. Okay, I can sing. You guys have to be ready with your hoorays though, right? Ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Amanda. Happy birthday to you. Hip hip. I'm waiting. Hooray. Hip hip. Hip hip. Yay. I don't know how old you are, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and one for good luck.
Because we all legal up in this bitch. I'm sorry I'm not the best singer, especially since I haven't slept. Hip hip hooray. I guess I can give you a hip hip hooray. Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. How have they been selling? I don't know. Between you and me, I only make like $17 per sale, so I kind of prefer it when people go through Ule's Gumroad and buy them there. Because then, yeah, more money. But that just means you have to go get them printed yourself somewhere else, so yeah, it is up to you. I think I won't get paid until 3 months from now, so I won't know how many I've sold until then. Kind of sucks. But I have been assured that Cuddly Octopus has optimal quality. So there we go. You know what, Zaroid? Life went really quickly for me. 24. Up until I was 24, it was going so slow. I remember like every single day. And then after 24, man alive. It just zoomed by.
Thank you. You are a gem.
That's okay, Leogree. Thank you very much for the dollary dues. Helps me a lot. Maybe I will get myself a ducky after all. But I hope your girl, I hope your wife has a lovely birthday. What are you doing for it though? How are you spoiling her? How are you showing her the queen she is? Yeah. 27, then you're like, oh, I'm suddenly 30. Where the fuck did that come from? Especially because, when was I? I think I was 29 when COVID started. So yeah, very much zoomed by for me. What's a carbonella? Carbonella. I don't know what the carbonella is. The carbonella is. I'm out of water. Well, sticky mouth. Do you mean you're making her carbonara? A candelabra, maybe? Hello, monkey DJ Ajang. You guys have some whack-ass screen names. Well, Cabanara. I knew it! See, I was just being facetious, but the fact I was real. Cabanara, yum. You make me hungry. I'm fucking hungry. Oh, what I wouldn't give for a cheese toasty. Grilled cheese. I cook a mean Cabanara. And, oh my god, I forgot to tell you guys, I made that pesto pasta from that movie Luca last week. They have an official recipe on the Disney Pixar site. It was amazing. Well, it's amazing that they tried. But I must say, it was incredibly complicated to make and it tasted not that great. It was quite, I don't know, tasteless really. But what you do is you get like a bunch of pine nuts, some pesto, some garlic, salt, a bunch of other shit. And you can get a mortar and pestle and like sort of smash it up. But I got sick of that, so I used a food processor. And like I use way too many noodles. Sorry, fettuccine. And when you toss it in the fettuccine, it's like, eh. I was adding so much pepper and so much, what's that cheese? Fucking, oh, the fuck, we put on everything. Come on, brain. Fucking wake up. Parmesan. Yeah, Parmesan. I had oodles of Parmesan all over it. It was disgusting, so I just had to add so much shit to it to try and make it taste like anything. So I think next time I make it, I'm gonna double the recipe just so I had enough sauce on it. I love me some sauce. And never ever use only 2 cloves of garlic. It's a fucking waste of time. Always use double the garlic they tell you to. I'm telling you right now.
But yeah, you make me hungry now. But I haven't gone food shopping, so I have no food. I really want pizza. Yum. I want carbonara. Oh. Maybe pasta cups open. Oh, look, the sun. Huh. Wow. How about that? It's fucking sun. Nuggies. I have some nuggies. Yum. Zao. I can't wait till my tea room's finished. We're gonna have some nice times in there. Gonna be a fancy schmancy. Might even be ready by next stream. Who knows? Ooh, ooh. Excuse me. Yep, I can tell I'm getting hungry because my body's like, oi. You're gonna have these herpes. Oh, Cyan, yeah, how'd the interview go? How'd it go? Proud of you. Proud of you so much. Oh.
Some biddies to hopefully help you in your pursuit of pizza, which means I also gotta depart sadly to make pizza.
Thanks, Derp Slack. 500 biddies. So kind. Well, if you're gonna make, like, handmade pizza, you need to be wifed up instantly. Amazing. What kind of pizza are you going to make? When will I stream again? I don't know. I've been way too depressed to stick to a schedule, so I guess whenever I feel like I've done enough work, when I'm feeling good in my head, when I don't have anything else to do, I'll stream. But I'd say for now, I'm not gonna stick to a schedule. I'm just gonna do it when I feel, because making a job is not something I want to do ever. I wanna have fun. And it's for me. This is something for me. It's like something I always wanted to do. It's really early, yeah. It's like 9 o'clock or something, 9 a.m. I just saw the sun peeking out through the curtains. I was like, oh. I guess I've been up all night again. Mm-hmm. So yeah, very early. Oh, dude. I would love to have like a pizza making stream. I don't know how that would work though. Would be fun. I don't have a webcam. Well, certainly not a portable one. Pulled pork pizza? Yum! My ideal pizza. Best pizza I ever had was... The base had like parmesan in the dough. So it was light, fluffy, just a little bit cheesy, delicious. And then it had a chili mango chutney base, the sauce. And then it had smoked chicken, little bits of like onion, avocado, mushroom, some spinach, and then all topped off with like lots of spices. Oh, my mouth was watering. And it had a little bit of pine nuts on the top. Oh, so good. You know what? A lot of people think I'm weird for like an avocado on pizza. I beg to differ. Yum. Yeah, I'll call it Tiger Tan special pizza. You can always clip it. You can always clip my amazing, pizza recipe. Oh, also it had brie. No, camembert cheese slices scattered around it. And also, mozzarella, of course. But yeah, the camembert cheese really, so good. Oh, I'm hungry. Yes, my favorite pizza place used to be this place called Hell's Pizza. I'm pretty sure it's only New Zealand, though. And then crust pizza is good. I like crust pizza. You're in Japan, Wolfie Chew fan. Holy crap. I'm pretty amazed that you know English and stuff. That's cool. I was considering having like a little translator down the bottom that could translate English to Japanese, but I don't think I have that many Japanese viewers. Never order pizza in Japan. I will tell you, when I was in Japan, I had some... I went to this, like, quote-unquote Italian place. I have never had pasta with that much garlic in it. It was a lot. It was a lot of garlic. I was like, do not ever serve this to Nonna. Nonna would be like, you know, a Italian grandmother. And I love garlic. I fucking love garlic. But man, whoo, it was a lot. Mind you, I went with a whole bunch of people who didn't even want to try Japanese food. So my mistake. They were like, let's go to Starbucks. Let's see what Japanese McDonald's is like. I was like, you have to be joking. I'm going to go to this ramen shop real quick. Get a full big bowl of ramen for like $7. You enjoy Starbucks, which you can get literally anywhere in the world. And it's the same shit. Go ahead. Make my day. So basic. No, at the time when we were in Japan, they had tiny little McDonald's everywhere. They weren't big restaurants that you could actually go into and sit in. They were kind of kiosks, really. You sit there and they bring you the food. And they were promoting some kind of new burger. I don't actually know what it was called, but to the point where you would go into these little McDonald's kiosks and that's all you could order was this burger. You couldn't just go on McChicken and be like, no, all we have is this burger. Maybe you can get some fries, maybe you can get a drink with it, but you can't get anything else. And I thought that was so strange. I was like, if you did this in America, there would be actual riots in the streets. They'd be like, I want my McNuggets! What do you mean McFlurry machine is down? Or it doesn't exist in this McDonald's, apparently. Yeah. But no, it was very high quality. I was very impressed. But then again, I've had pretty shit food in America, not gonna lie. American cuisine is probably the worst I've ever had, ever. And I've traveled a lot. I've had food from a lot of different countries. America's was the worst. I got stomach aches all the time because I don't know what you fucking put in your food, but it, ugh. I don't know. Did not agree with me. I've even had fucking street food in Indonesia, which you're apparently meant to get sick from. I was fine. And I'm good with cheese. I'm half white, so I'm good with that. I'm not lactose intolerant. White people love their cheese. Yeah, the chain restaurant. Although I liked International House of Pancakes. I liked IHOP. We had some pretty good eggs there. Because everywhere else I went, it was powdered eggs. And I thought that was disgusting. Yeah, corn syrup was weird. And you guys had, yeah, no natural sugar. It was just the corn syrup. Now it's IHOB, isn't it? But no, I just told the waitress, I was like, I'm so sick of powdered eggs. I've never had them in my life until I came here. I'm crying, man. I just want a good coffee. Not this black shit. I want a barista-made coffee. I want real eggs. I want real bacon that isn't burnt to a crisp. Please. Maybe some grits. No, wait, grits are nasty. And yeah, she threw down. She really put her foot in it, and I gotta say, very much enjoyed IHOB. Waffle House. I never went to Waffle House. I didn't go to very many places now I think about it. Yeah, we just sort of had food at home. I've never had Arby's. Or, what was the other one? The Italian, what's it called? It's not breadsticks, that's from fucking Glee. Fuck. It's a big Italian a big Italian chain you guys have over there? Olive Garden. Olive Garden. I really want to go to an Olive Garden. I want the free breadsticks, okay? Olive Garden.
I need to run errands, but thanks for your time.
Oh.
I'll see the rest of this stream on YouTube.
Thank you very much, and happy birthday to the missus. I wasn't actually planning on putting this on YouTube, but now I have to, I guess. Damn it. Breadsticks. I've had Denny's before. I think so. Ugh. I might actually go. I don't have a lot left to say, I must say. Yes. Yes. My voice is kind of going and I'm hungry. I'm very hungry. And it's 9 a.m. I probably can't get anything good because I hate breakfast food. But we'll see what I have around. See me happy? Oh! I mean, I'm not happy. I'm performing, but you know... You don't need to know that. You don't need to know my secrets. I'm not okay. Well, indeed. But if I can brighten up your day even a little, it was worth coming on today. A breakfast pizza.
Eat a breakfast pizza.
It sounds amazing. I want a breakfast pizza. No, I'm gonna have baked beans and cheese on toast. I think that'll be delicious. Yes.
I am glad to see you back and look forward to seeing you stream again when you are feeling better.
Oh, thanks, Cyan. Sorry for the weird timings I'm having. I'm having a weird time, but I'll just see you when I see you. It's only goodbye for now. Yeah, yeah. So sorry that there is, you know, not much of a schedule happening at the moment.
Well, I'm back for a little while. How are all you beautiful people doing today?
Oh, hi, Prune Pilfera. Thank you very much for subscribing. Sorry your last sub kind of went to useless because I didn't stream. But, yeah. I think there was somebody I was meant to raid. Give me a moment. This person helped me out quite a bit at one point. Where are they? Haha. I promised them a raid many, many, many moons ago. And I feel bad that I never did, so... We're gonna raid this person called Grabnok. Please give them a follow. It'll absolutely make their day. I think they have like 15.
Thank you for being on. So. I had an absolutely awful day and this made me feel a bit better.
Oh, that is so sweet. I'm really sucks that you had an awful day, of course. I'm sorry. I didn't have a great one either, but you know, we lift each other's spirits. We can do. So bye for now. I'll see y'all again. We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know when. Bye bye. Mwah. Love ya. Please give them follow. There we go. Okie dokie.